All right, and welcome to the chat room now. Bonnie Schneider here. This is kind of one of the highlights of our hour. We get to talk about all those funny little, sometimes quippy things out there that we think need a little airtime, including pro football player Chad Ochocinco and his cereal and a big old boo-boo.
That's right. It was pulled from the shelves because of a really bad typo. Unfortunately, it included a phone number that's supposed to belong to the charity Feed the Children, but the number is actually a sex line.
Oh,
Feed the Children said they accidentally sent the wrong number to the cereal company.
Yeah, so it's Feed the Children's error, and not necessarily the cereal company or even Ochocinco. In fact, Ochocinco even had a comment. He tweeted about it, right? He says he feels absolutely horrible about it. Do we have that that quote from him? Okay, the answer is no, but I'm going to paraphrase.
I mean, yeah. That's the last thing you want.
He says, hey, you're trying to do something good, and then something like this happens. He apologized to everybody, and they're trying to do the right thing by pulling the cereal from the shelves.
Next time, check the number before you print it.
Yeah, I think so. We do that. You know, that's a practice we do. We get a phone number. We always check it before we put it on the air. And that's just a practice you got to do, especially if you're in the business of a cereal box, too.
That's
and you got kids who are buying the cereal.
Good point.
All right, that's my little commentary for the day, right? Just a little encouragement. Okay, now let's talk about the brainiest cities out there. Some no-brainers. We know Washington, D.C. tops the list.
And look who's from Washington, D.C. Again, so many universities there.
Yeah,
that's not surprising at all.
Brilliant city. And then there's a list for what they say, I guess, the less intelligent, less educated.
Right, but this doesn't mean
All right, now, how about, as we're going on this list of cities that have made a name for themselves, there are also cities that some would say are rather haunted.
Well, it's October now. We're getting closer to Halloween, so we have to start thinking of places to go for Halloween that are a little scary out there.
Yeah.
Well, Massachusetts, because I used to live in Boston, and it is fun. They have the witches and the parade.
That's
a great time for Halloween.
Yeah, and you talk about old cities, Charleston, South Carolina. You know, talk about some of these old cities with, you know, pretty significant past, too.
Right.
Charleston, South Carolina being a big slave port. You know, some might want to draw some connections there, the type of history associated with, and like you said, you know, Salem and witches. And again, it's Halloween season,
it's
so why not, right? And then let's talk about something that I guess is
fun.
Growing up so fun for so many people, the Flintstones. Yay to the Flintstones, turning 50 this week, 1960.
I can't believe I didn't know that.
Yeah, mm-hmm. Yeah.
That's great. Well, 50,
so
happy birthday,
just like that Dino kind of sticking his head through the convertible of the top there, or like there.
Definitely.
Flintstones, love them.
Yeah, happy birthday.
Happy
50
birthday
years
to the Flintstones. And of course, you know, when the Flintstones came out, you know what's interesting about that? It was the first television show on American television to show a man and a woman in bed together.
Oh, I didn't know that.
Yeah, Fred and Wilma.
Wow.
It was all clean cut stuff. But, you know, it was a cartoon to appeal to both adults and children. And it did then.
Yeah,
it has forever. It lives on. 50 and still strong.
That's right.
All right, Bonnie, thanks so much.
Oh, it was
fun.
We'll
see you a lot later because we still got some crazy weather in the East Coast and other places, too.
Sounds good.
All right, thanks. All right, so here's a question for you, a pretty alarming one, too. What would you do if your child was kidnapped and taken overseas and you knew where your child was, but you were not allowed to actually get your child back? It's a troubling problem for many American parents, and we'll look at how U.S. lawmakers are trying to fix that.